Hey, what's up guys? How is it going? In today's project, we are going to learn how to build a simple face blurring project using Python and OpenCV. So we start off from scratch and we'll build this app to the top. So we have some couple of few steps we'll follow in this project, such as importing our libraries. Then we have to get our video feed from the camera, after which we have to detect this face, extract the boundary around this face, then we apply the blur. Then the final step is to what? Put this face back on our original face. Then we are done with this project. If you are glad about this and today is your first time visiting my channel, do me a favor by striking the like button on and also putting me on post notification. Don't also forget to subscribe as well, which helps me and motivates me to produce quality videos for you guys. So let's get started. Alrighty, so let's import the libraries we'll need. We'll need OpenCV, so I'll go import CV2. And also from CV zone, we'll import our face tracking, which makes everything easy. Okay, so these are the two libraries we'll be using for this particular project. We use OpenCV to get our feed from the camera, and we'll use CV zone to detect the faces. It has a module in it called face detector, which by using only one line of code, we'll be able to detect a particular face in a video or an image as well. So the next step here is to get the video feed from the camera. Let's stream a live video feed of myself from the camera. Then we'll try to detect this face on it. And it's very simple. We have to create a capture object. So we say cap is equal to the CV2, the video capture. And that's it. So in here you put in the camera ID. So if you have only one camera, then you have to just put 0 here. But you have many cams hooked to your computer, then try using 0, 1, 2 and so on to get the actual camera to work with. And since we are going to be doing this on a video field, we have to take the video feed in the while loop. So we say while true, which is the same as while one. True means one. That's the logic. We'll take our video feed, which returns not only the video feed but also a boolean value which shows the presence or absence of a video feed. Then the next thing will be our video frame, which is equal to cap.read. We've gotten our feed with just this line of code. Now we need to go ahead and show it. So we say cv2.unshow to provide a window name called frame. Then finally, let's show our video. After showing, we need to wait and take this each frame. So we use a wait key function, which is pretty much easy. Then we put in 1 here, which means we are taking each frame each second. So with these few lines of code, we are able to get our video feed from the webcam. So let's run this app and see what we have. And boom guys, here you have it. So you can see me live in the video stream. Everything is working just as charm. So now we'll close this off because we have one objective done. And the next step is to get our face detector on because we are getting our live feed. So let's get our face detected from this live feed. So for that, we need to create a face detector object here. So I'll just call this FD, which stands for face detector. It's kind of weird. I know you can give it a better name than that, and this is equal to just face detector, and that's all. So with this, we have created a face detector, and to find a face, all you need to do is just write fd.findFace, and guess what, you just need to put in your video here, and that's it. So with this, when you run this, any face found, we have a bounding box around every face in this frame if any face is detected. So let's see how it will work out. So here you have it guys, you can see I have a bounding box detected on my face, which is detecting the face accurately. So you can see the accuracy on it. When I hide behind the microphone, it's about 50 something. When I come out, 96, which is working pretty much good, right? So you can see the accuracy is good and our face is literally being detected very well. So the thing is, now we have to go ahead and extract the bounding box information from this particular face, or let's get this face out. Then we'll blur this face and put this face back on. So let's get the coordinates for this face fixed, and then we can apply blur on these coordinates. Okay, so we'll come down here and we'll start with, if there is any face, okay, before that, this returns to us our faces and the image. So let's take this one first. So it will return image, and it will also return us with our face. So this is equal to a bit of a, so we'll say if any face is found, then we'll go ahead and get the information, bounding box information from this face. So we'll get the X, we'll get the Y, we'll also get the width and the height, and this is equal to the face in the key of, it's a dictionary, so we have to take it at the first index, then in the key of BB box. So we just write BBOX, which stands for bounding box in this particular situation. So this is our bounding box information. We can print to verify. So I'll print X, Y, width, and height to verify the particular information we are having about the bounding box. So let's run it up. So here you have it, guys. You can see the bounding box information being printed, and it's just changing as we are going around with our face. As the face is moving, it will also be moving just as well. So now let's just get the region of interest, which is our face now, from the actual video stream. And to get that, we'll say, okay, that's our image, or let's give it face image is equal to a list of, so we are taking it from the Y, which is the top, all the way to Y plus the height. Then the second part of it is we are taking it from X, then to all the way, that will be X plus the width. So our face image is equal to this, but we are taking it from our video, so we put our video here and we extract this particular portion out of it. So what we can do is also show only this face image if you guys like, which I think will give us more understanding of whatever we are doing. So we can show only the face image this time to see whether we are extracting only the face from the whole body. And I can repeat this so that we show the body as well, then we can compare. So for this one is our video, and let's run. Okay, so that's not showing, I don't know why. So let's check and see what we are not doing right. Oh, okay, so we are showing them on frame. So let's give this one face. We are showing face. Okay, it's a mistake. This rather should be our face, and then the other one, which is our video frame. So the problem was that we are showing all on frame, which shouldn't be the case. So boom, here we are. You can see this our face. At this corner we are getting only the face, and here we are getting the whole body. So now we will apply the blur on this extracted face, and then we'll cast it back onto this face so that it will look the same, and we'll have our blur. So that's the final part of this whole project. Let's go ahead and finish it up. Okay, so to blur this, we just say face, our face image is equal to cv2.blur, that blur function, and in here we provide whatever we want to blur. So we want to blur our face image, and we have to give this a candle size of 35 by 35, which shows the blur intensity, and that's it. So with this, you have blurred this face, and the final step we are going to do now is to put this back on the original video. So we can just say our video in the same key of Y to Y. So I can just copy whatever we have here into it once again, and now this is equal to our face image, and that's it. So we can choose to show both the face image and the video once again so that we'll see the difference. So let's run this up, and here you have it, guys. So you can see we have successfully blurred our face. We can move like this, we can move like this, and we don't know it is me because my face is being blurred. You can see our little face extracted. So we are casting this back. back onto our original face, and you see everything is working just as a charm. So guys, this is a fun project and very simple one. Of course, this is for beginners to understand and also build this little mini project. So it's fun. Let me have your reactions in the comment section. Let me know what you'll be using this for, a way you think we can do this in an advanced way. I'm ready for your thoughts, guys. So if you enjoyed it up to this session, kindly give me a thumbs up and also subscribe if you are new. Share with one or two friends and let's grow the community together. So thanks for coming around, guys. I will see you guys in the next upcoming video.